A big thank you to White Rabbit for bringing this video to all of you via Patreon. Yarrick the Desecrated Lands Matter versus the Ur-Dragon. We have our mana set there, so we'll certainly keep. We're on the draw as well. Our opponent shocks themselves with a steam vent and goes in for the mana crypt, so there's propaganda. Buying themselves some time. They go down to 4 cards though. There's no need for us to go anywhere near that fast. We do have the Triome in the list now, so we'll go for that here. Made a few little changes to this Lands Matter list. It is, well, lots more Lands Matter-y. Cavern of Souls, Naming Dragon. We're not running any counter magic in this deck anyway, I don't think. Hinterland Harbor comes in untapped thanks to the Triome, and we can go secure a Tribe Elder. Don't think we need to worry about any Hasters, but I'll hold that up anyway. Managing to dodge both the Mana Crypt flips here. And there we have a Dragon Lord Servant, so I'm guessing that's what they've drawn into for the turn. Makes their dragons cost one less. And at the end of the turn, I think, yeah, I don't know how many coloured pips we have here. It's probably mostly green. So let's go for a forest. And then if we cultivate on this turn, we can go for a blue and a black source with that. A polluted delta is fine. Not getting into any of the Lands Matter triggers, unfortunately. Maybe we can just ramp up to the Zendikar Resurgent. And they know about the swamp that's in our hand, but we'll just get down the Overgrown Tomb tapped. Save ourselves a little bit of life, might be relevant against a dragon player. So if we're not going to get into too many Lands Matter things, I wonder if it's worth going Crucible of Worlds next turn. We can play the Misty Rainforest. Then go into Zendikar Resurgent the turn after and use all the double mana to go Villainous Wealth. Try and get a bunch of dragons into play. Our opponent's struggling on coloured lands apparently. So Cloud Key will make it cost one less, which will total two less, thanks to the Dragon Lord Servant as well. Speaking of which, we get poked for one by that. They did get bolted last turn because they're at 25 now. Damnation's fine. So if they do manage to slam a bunch of dragons into play, then we're not necessarily going to have to worry about that. So we'll play out the Crucible. Play out the Misty Rainforest. And we can pretend to hold up counter magic there, I think. We're probably just tapping out into Zendikar Resurgent next turn. The double mana will be useful against the propaganda as well, assuming that we can't blow it up. And there we go, managing to get into a Bayou, so they should be able to cast a dragon here. And it is Daragaz reincarnated, Flying Trample and Haste. Yeah, that's something to worry about. We're going to struggle to keep that out of play with Damnation. Hopefully we can get into a big dragon or two with Villainous Wealth and we can just chump block it. So let's get another Shockland into play tapped, because it is going to be relevant this game, I think, the amount of life that we take. Okay, Vamp Tutor, do we take a turn off here and blow the board up? We've got 3 turns after this goes down. We're taking a hit for 8 next turn, which knocks us down to 11. I don't particularly like that. So we can go for... We've got one more Shockland in Breeding Pool, so we'll grab that with the Misty Rainforest. We've got Vamp Tutor as well. Let's just go for the Damnation here. It takes them down a little bit of mana as well. So the Daragaz gets exiled with some egg counters on it. We will... pass the turn at that. We've got the Vamp Tutor and the Misty Rainforest held up. And they go down to 19 thanks to the Mana Crypt. We just have to keep our fingers crossed that they can't go for... Alright. Well, the Urborg does make all of our lands black, which I don't think is going to be relevant, but might be. If we go down too much life, then we might want to tap the fetches. Elvish Piper. I mean, they've got enough mana to cast dragons anyway, I think, so not necessarily too worried about that. Although maybe they've got a huge dragon that they can't quite afford. So let's go for the Vamp Tutor here. And I think it's worth us getting... Yeah, probably the Tatyova into play. Maybe even the Royal Elemental would be a good idea. So that we can start stealing things from them. But let's go for the Tatyova so that we can start gaining bits of life and keeping ourselves in cards. Actually forgot to crack the Misty Rainforest, but I don't think it matters. We've got plenty of landfall. It's probably best keeping it in play, actually, for when we get the Tatyova out. So right now we'll go Zendikar Resurgent. And we can throw down the Polluted Delta. And we'll hope that we keep hold of the Zendikar Resurgent this turn. Not much of a Lands Matter game so far. but we are holding off the dragons quite nicely, I hope. Darragaz will come in again next turn. Yeah, maybe it was worth going for the Roiling Oracle or whatever it's called. Because with the fetches, we can steal stuff at instant speed. So it's time to see if the Elvish Piper is going to get anything of relevance into play. Instead, just hardcasting a Wasitora. So that will make some tokens for them. I think we're just going to windmill slam this Villainous Wealth next turn, try and get a bunch of dragons from them. Okay, Miri's Guile is decent. Not too worried about getting Miri's Guile into play though. Let's go for the Swamp. And we'll go for this Villainous Wealth. I don't even know what X is going to be. X is 15, so we should be able to cast whatever we show here. Alright, there's surprisingly few dragons there. We'll go for Crux of Fate on last. Not a vast number of dragons. Dragon Master Outcast will get us into dragons. Sunbird's Invocation is good. Ramos is fine. Alright, well, we'll start getting this stuff down. We'll get some decent life gain from the Sunscorched region, as well as the Tatyova as well. So then Fractured Identity can come into play. We'll just take them... Yeah, we'll take away their Mana Crypt. Crux of Fate can destroy all dragons. That's why we're putting it on the stack last, so it will resolve first. We can blow up their dragon from out of the sky. And then we draw cards. So we blow up their dragon. Fractured Identity gets rid of some mana. And now we're getting into all of their creatures. Got a Sunbird's Invocation. Belby's Portal, which we'll probably just name Elemental. I think we've got more Elementals in here than anything else. Slate of Ancestry, don't think we're going to be making use of. We do have that extra mana though. So we can get this Tatyova into play. Do we want to get Lightning Greaves down instead? They might just have some kind of board wipe. Yeah, I think it's best going for the Lightning Greaves. So Sunbird's Invocation will trigger. We'll get plus counters on the Ramos if it has any colours, which it obviously doesn't. Lands on top, doesn't do anything. And then we might as well throw down that Miri's Guile as well. So again, triggering Sunbird's Invocation. Not likely it's going to do anything. Yeah, just revealing Field of the Dead. And then we'll shove Lightning Greaves onto the Ramos. And we're going to start getting Dragon Tokens next turn. So let's swing in this Ramos at our opponent. Knock them down to 11. And we do have to pay the 2 mana for that, of course, which we got from the rocks. Okay, so pretty explosive turn, I think. 15 mana into X on a Villainous Wealth. The Darragaz will come back into play here. I wonder if they've got any kind of double strike that they can go for. Casting Silumgar into the Dragon Scorch region. And that is... Yeah, creatures defending player controls get -1/-1, so we lose the Dragon Master Outcast. Every time I have this on my side of the field, it never sees through to the end of the turn. Never ever get any dragons off that thing. So that Silumgar triggers on attacks. It will minus everything down. That is 7 damage coming through to us. Will knock us down to 10. Our opponent has tapped out, so we don't have to worry about any kind of double strike. We will just take it here, I think. And now we've got a serious turn incoming, I think. So hopefully don't get bolted by the crypt. We've got Miri's Guile to have a look at some stuff on top. Alright, the Great Henge makes it even better. We'll go Drowned Catacomb. Draw into... We want to draw into both, so we'll just shove both of them on top. We'll be able to draw both of them thanks to the Tatyova. We do get bolted, so I've got to be careful here against a dragon player. Throw down Yarrick, first of all. Ramos getting way bigger. Then we can go for the Tatyova. Really making use of the double mana here. Draw a card with the Zendikar Resurgent. Sunbird's Invocation will trigger. More counters on the Ramos. And we do get an Assassin's Trophy, so let's... Can we not blow this up? Oh, it has Hexproof, okay. So maybe we just go for the Darragaz again. Counters continually going onto the Ramos, of course. And our opponent decides to scoop there, that's fair enough. I think we're about to start going off there. Once Tatyova's in play, we can play the Cabal Coffers and the Great Henge. Maybe should have played Great Henge before Tatyova actually, but we've got plenty of life to gain there thanks to Sunscorched Regent as well. and then we're just going to refill our hand, and our opponent's going to have the hardest time getting past us. Pretty good one, I think. Not much of a lands matter game. It started to become one in the end, but more of a villainous wealth game. If you want to see more from this Yarrick Lands Matter list, then you have to be sure to hit the like button, because I do pay attention to that as well as the views. If no one clicks on it to view it, then I won't bother. But decided to get some quick 1v1 games in because I am away for a couple of weeks and needed to get some quick content for all of you. So now is your chance to, again, try to keep the 1v1s around. I'm Tribal Kai on the EDH channel. Thank you for watching.